to epicartdesigns.com. On today's video, we're going to show you how to edit one of our funeral programs using the free version of Canva. So let's get started. When you purchase a template from us, it comes in a PDF file. If you have any trouble locating this file, just contact us at the email that's listed on the screen or in the description box below, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. So go ahead and follow these instructions that's on the PDF. You're going to click here for template, and it's going to lead you to a template. It's going to lead you to a page on Canva where it shows you a template has been shared with you. Okay, so now what you have here is your template with all the pages and the design elements. The first step we're going to do is we're going to go into removing the background. This is a very important step to show you guys, because when you're using the free version of Canva, they don't allow you to use their background remover. So I'm going to show you guys an alternative that's really easy to do. Okay, so go ahead and open a new tab, and you're going to search remove.bg. It will be on the screen, and a link will be in the description for you guys. So it's going to take you to the screen. Just go ahead and upload your image. Again, this is 100% free, and you don't really have to make an account. So you could if you want to, but I personally don't do it. So this is your image. You removed it just like that, and go ahead and download it. So I'm going to go back over to Canva and just drop my image from the top. Or if you don't have that on your laptop, just go to Uploads, Upload File, and it should be right there. Okay, so now that the background is removed, let's go ahead and get into the second step, which is creating this picture frame effect. Okay, so just so I can make this a little bit easier, I group layers on the templates. You'll see this in your template, so you can ungroup it. So go ahead and ungroup that. We're going to right click on this. I'm just going to show you an easy way to locate the layers. Right click, go to layers, and go all the way down to show layers. So you'll see on the side you have all your layers kind of laid out right there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is drag the image that I just uploaded below the template image. And you're just going to select that template image and delete it. Delete that one too. You'll see in a minute while that one's right there. Okay, so that's deleted. Now I'm just going to go ahead and select my image. And I'm just going to make sure that it's lined up how I want it. You'll see it's like her arm is sticking out at the bottom. I want that, make sure that's not sticking out and that's in the frame. So I'm just going to cut it off. We want the bottom in and the top out. So now we're just going to go ahead and duplicate this layer and try to line it up as best as you can. So it's going to be a little hard to see, but I kind of broke cut the layer up off some so that it's only showing her head at the top. And you'll have to zoom in so you can kind of line it up, if you can see what I'm doing. Kind of line it up so that everything fits properly. So it still looks a little bit off, but I'm gonna get it. You just have to play around with it and line it up. Don't change the size because it's definitely not gonna line up after that. So Canva should click it in place if you're pretty close. So just like that. Also, keep in mind, if you have any parts just cut off on your image, it will look like that in the frame. So in this case, the top of her head is cut off, so it's showing in the frame. Okay, so now I want to show you guys how to group the frame, okay? But before we group them, we got to lock the rest of the layers, because you don't want other layers getting grouped that you don't want grouped. So what you see me doing is highlighting all the other layers except the layers I want to group, and just locking it with the icon that's in the, it'll either be on the top right, or it'll be floating on the top of the element once highlighted. So you see I went to the three dots that's on the top right and just locked it. So I made sure that it was locked. Now I grouped and there we have it. Okay, so I showed you guys how to lock an element. Now I'm gonna show you how to unlock an element. We get so many questions on these and I just wanna clear it up. So if it's locked, it'll be like a lock icon highlighted over the element. Just select that, or it'll be at the top left by positions, and now it's unlocked. Okay, now let's get into changing these background colors, okay? All our templates have 100% changeable background colors, so just go ahead and do that layer trick we learned earlier to locate the layers, and locate the color that you want to change, or locate the layer that has the wrong color in it, should I say, and just go ahead and change it. You might have to do it a few times because it's multiple layers, but just do it until you get your desired style. Now I want to change my text color because it is blending into my background. So I'm just going to go to the color tool and you'll see it has a little A icon at the top. I'm going to change it to white. I did notice it is still blending in with the clouds and everything. So I'm just going to show you how to add the shadows to the text. So just make sure your text is selected. Go to effects. You can either do a lift, but I highly recommend using a shadow. It gives you a more powerful effect. So I'm just going to change it to black. You can copy my settings, feel free to. I turn the transparency up quite a lot, actually. And then I turn the blur up, and you can already see it's like a big difference, a huge difference. So what you'll see me doing here is like little customization options. I'm finishing up changing those background colors. I will change the text color. So just kind of watch and see, and you can go ahead and along and kind of customize this to make it yours. So I also want to show you how to group and change the text all at once because I want it to be as easy as possible for you. So let's go ahead and do that, grouping and changing it. So just like we did with that other picture frame, we're just going to make sure that the layers that we don't want grouped is locked because you don't want to select those and just group it and change the color for those. So just go ahead and lock it. Once you have that, just highlight over your text, go to the text color icon and change it, and there you have it. All of it's changed to white. You could even change the size, like you could just do it all together. It's so much easier. Okay, now so say you don't want our backgrounds, you want to add your own background. So I'm going to show you how to do that as well. So go ahead and locate your background. It might take me a while to find it. It usually has you like filter from free to pro, but I guess they're not giving me the option this time. So I'm just going to choose one and you'll see me do that. Okay, so I have my background now. I'm just going to crop it to size to fit this the cover. Going to go to layers, show layers, and I'm just going to make sure it's dragged below all the elements of my design. So it's like a block there. I'm just going to make sure it's above that block. You can even delete it. Make sure, yeah, so yeah, just go ahead and drag it above there. And then I like to turn the transparency down because I don't like it to be overpowering, but it's completely up to you. You can keep it up or you can turn it down. So we try to make it as easy as possible for you guys. So we use frames for the photos and the collages. So I'm just going to show you how to drop your pictures in the grids or frames. So what you want to do is locate your photos and uploads. You can either upload a new one or just use one that's there and drop it in there. So you can crop it by clicking it and going to crop at the top left. just like I did. And you can change the size of this, you can rotate it. If you don't like cut off pictures, it's up to you how you want to do it. But I'm just going to size it down. Yeah. And you could just do this. So you'll see right here, the grid, you can like change the size of it. It's different from frames. If you were just to use a frame, you have to stick to that desired shape. That's why we love using grids in our templates. And that concludes this video, guys. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us at the email in the description box below. Follow us on our social media for more content. And if you want to purchase a template, visit our website at epicartdesigns.com. Thanks for watching. Bye.